Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Luke Swinkels, and welcome back to How to Compose Classical Music for Dummies. This is Lesson 6. Lesson 6, we will first revisit last week's topic, as I always do, and then we will go to ear training, which is the most important thing of today's lesson. And after that, we will do two small topics, which are on how to read notes, which are the extra lines, leisure lines, and accidentals. So first, Last week we talked about major and minor chords, scales, and how to identify the key of a piece. Do you remember how we did it in last week's lesson? Well, look at the score below. In what key is it? What is always to look for first? Always key signature and clef. So please pause the video and think for yourself. In which key is the piece written down below? You have an answer? Well, let's see. We see four sharps. So what does this mean? Well, we have a circle of fifths. So one, two, three, four. It is in E major or in one, two, three, C minor. Right? So what notes do we see in the last measure? We see an E, G sharp, B, E sharp, B, E. So a lot of E, B and G sharps. So can we make C sharp minor without the C sharp? Nope. So it is in E major. If you don't know how this was done, I would highly recommend you to watch lesson 5 first. So now, for today's lesson, it's mostly on ear training. Ear training is really, really important. You can train your ear what you actually hear. You know where you're listening to. Today, we will start off really simple with identifying the difference between the major and minor scale, the difference between major and minor chords, and three intervals, which is new. So first, major or minor scale. Do you guys know the difference? Major was bright, was more joyful, was more happy. And a minor scale is a bit more darker, it's more serious, and it is a bit more sad. So here I have five scales. And I would like for you to tell if the scales are in major key or a minor scale. The first. Is this major or minor? How does it sound? It sounds really relaxing or joyful or bright. It is a major scale. The second. Is this almost the same as the first one or much darker? Well, let's listen to it again. The second scale is also a major scale. This is the third one. Is this major or minor? It sounds not that bright as the first two. It sounds a bit more darker, if you can hear that, the difference. I can show you, listen to the second again. Ba-da-da-da-da. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. The third one is in a minor scale. The fourth. Is this major or minor? The fourth one is major again. And the fifth and final one. And again, fifth one. The fifth one is in minor. And here are the answers. The first two were in major, third one minor, fourth major, and the final one was in minor. We will add more scales and modes to this on my channel later. Now chords, major or minor, and it's about the same as with major or minor scale. The major scale is a bit brighter, more happier. Minor is a bit more sad, more darker, more serious, and it's the same with chords. A major chord to me sounds really happy, and a minor chord to me sounds a bit more sad without any other chords. This is the first chord. Is this a major or a minor chord? Ba, 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 bum. That's not really joyful, is it? It is a minor chord. Is this the second chord? Is it bright? Is it dark as well? Or does this sound more happier? The second chord is not like the first one. The second is a major chord. It is much brighter and it sounds more joyful. And the third and final chord. Is this a major or a minor chord? The third one is minor again. The first and third were minor and the second was major. In the next lesson or the lesson after that, we will introduce a new chord which we will add to our ear training list. But I think the difference between major and minor is pretty easy. Now something new, now intervals. So first, what is an interval? An interval is the distance between two things, and in music theory, the distance between two notes. We will start with the easiest of all. It's too easy that I almost forgot it, but if you hear two notes that are exactly the same, it's called a perfect unison. There is no space between these notes, they are perfectly the same, it's called a perfect unison. For instance, C and C, or if you hear two E's or two G flats, two the exact same notes. From C to D is a whole note, so there is a distance now, and D is the second note of C major, so interval CD is called the major seconds. It is the first and second note of the major scale after each other or together. And it sounds like this. And happy birthday. Birthday, for instance, begins with a major seconds. Happy birthday to you. Dore. And the last interval of the day is the major third. From C to E are two whole notes, and E is the third note of C major, so the interval CE is called the major third, and it sounds like this. Major third, do re mi. And Vivaldi's Four Seasons start with a major third, the spring part. Ba ba ba, do re mi. Now, let's see. What interval do you hear? Let's start with the first one. Well, is it the same note? No, it's not. So it's either a major second or a major third. Happy birthday to you is how you can remember that it is a major second. Or you can just sing out the major scale. It's the first and second note of the major scale. So it's called a major seventh. The next interval. It should not take too long to think about this, because it's just the same note twice. And we call this a perfect unison. The fifth interval. This time it's not the exact same note, so is it a major seventh or a major fifth? This is a major seventh. You can sing out the major scale if you want, or you can remember it with happy birthday. And the fourth and final interval. What interval is this? It's not the same note, so it's either a major seventh or a major fifth. It is a major fifth. In the upcoming weeks, I will add more intervals to the list, but we start easy. Now we are done with ear training for today, let's do something else. I will talk about lectured lines. In classical music, most instruments have five lines, but sometimes we need more. And these extra stripes are called lectured lines. Because, well, if we need more, we just add more. And adding too much lines makes it difficult to read, so we most of the time don't add more than three. You can, and I mean, well, I think if you are playing the piano or if you are playing the violin, you might have more lectured lines sometimes. And how to read them is pretty straightforward. You just keep counting E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, etc, etc. G, F, E, D, C, B, and A. If you just know one reference note, for example, the first line is an E and the last line is an F, you can just keep counting till you are at the note you want to read. So, let's do that. Can you name these four notes? And be aware, the third and fourth note are in F clef, also known as bass clef. You can pause the video if you want and think for yourself first as to how these notes are named. So, do we have an answer? Well, the first note is pretty high, so the fifth line is an F in G clef, so one space above would be a G, an A, and a B. So this first note is a B. Second note, well, the first line is an E, so D, C. The second note is a C. Well, the third note, we are in F clef, so this is not a C anymore. The first line is now an G, so one space below is an F, and one space below that is an E. So the third note is an E. And the fourth and final note is pretty high. In F clef, the first line from above is an A, so one space above would be a B, and this note is a C. And here are the answers. And last topic of today is just also a really quick one, are accidentals. Because we talked a lot about major and minor, and in both cases we have 7 notes, but in music we have 12 notes. So if I compose in C major, I miss 5 notes. And sometimes I do not want to miss those notes, I want to use more than 7 notes. And that's where we use accidentals. So in the music below, we are in what key? Do you know which key this is? Or which key this most likely is? We have two sharps, so C, G, D. And it ends with a D, so it's most likely that this is in D. And in this case, we are. But I've not given enough information to know for sure, but it is in D. So, D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C sharp, D. Let's say I want to play a C instead of a C sharp. We use the natural symbol, which is this symbol here. We can see it with this C. This natural symbol says, yeah, I know we are in D major, we have a C sharp, but I want you to play a C natural. That does the natural symbol say. And next to it, we have a flat symbol. So yeah, we are on D major, we have B naturals, but for this measure, we will play a B flat instead of a B. That are the accidentals. And the accidentals are only for the remaining of that measure. So here is an example. We are in D, so this is a C sharp. This is a C. And for the remaining of this measure, it will stay a C, and in the next measure, it is a C sharp again. So only for the remaining of that measure. So, can you name all these notes? Just pause the video if you want, or maybe you can just name them very quickly. So, the first thing to look for, we are now in F clef, and we have two flats, B flat, E flat. So the first note is a D, C, B flat, A, B natural, because we have the natural symbol, C, this is a B flat again, C, D, E natural, and E natural again, because it's for the remaining of the measure, and an F. So today we did a lot of small things. We did ear training on scale chords intervals. We just did kind of a part three on how to read sheet music with lecture lines and accidentals. In the next lesson, I will talk about the term diatonic and diatonic triads. I will teach you the diminished chord with ear training. And if you have any questions on this lesson, please comment them down below. I am Lux Winkels, and I'll hopefully see you in next lesson on how to compose classical music for dummies. See ya!